ভবাপ বর্গ হমত যদা ভবিজ্জনস তর্হি অচ্যুত সৎসমাগমঃ সৎসঙ্গমজর্হি তদৈব সদ্গতো পরাবরেষে ত্বয়ি জয়তে রতিঃ। ভবাপ বর্গ হমত যদা ভবিজ্জনস তর্হি অচ্যুত সৎসমাগমঃ সৎসমাগম হি তদৈব সদ্গত পরাবরেষে ত্বয়ি জয়তে রতিঃ। শিশিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টোল, ইফ দ্য হোল ওয়ার্ল্ড গোয়িং এগেনস্ট মি, শিলা ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টোল, ইফ দ্য হোল ওয়ার্ল্ড গোয়িং এগেনস্ট মি অ্যান্ড দোজ হু আর কামিং টু মি অ্যাজ এ ডিসাইপল, অ্যাজ মাই ডিসাইপল, if they all one by one leave me and go away from me, still I am not going to stop speaking the absolute truth. To seek self interest is not bhakti. To seek personal interest, it is not actually bhakti. Bhakti means dedication. To seek personal interest is not at all bhakti. To seek the interest of Krishna is bhakti. And if you try to seek the interest of Krishna, you cannot satisfy the common people, I mean common world. Very often, very often Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada used to told, Parashabhava karmani na prasansayat na garahet vishwamekatmakam pashyana prakriti purushena cha. Then why was speaking so against Vaishnava? Somebody can chase me. I am not speaking anything against any Vaishnava. I am speaking all about the absolute truth. Srila Prabhupada used to advise you that try to find your own fault. That is my advice. Last moment when Prabhupada going away from this material world, Prabhupada giving some pieces of jewel advice. We cannot, never we can forget. Any advice given by Prabhupada. If you are really interested to go to Gauranga Mahaprabhu, I mean if you actually interested to climb that eternal abode, then there should not be any dissatisfaction. Koi gunjais ka koi rasta nahi. It was the last advice of Srila Prabhupada. Don't try to criticize anybody. Try to find your own fault and try to rectify yourself. That is my advice. Prabhupada. But Prabhupada himself speaking, many times you heard from me. What you heard? Why you take the trouble to get control over Guru Vishnu? Why you are going to find fault with Guru Vishnu? You try to find fault with you. Now sometime you can find some Siddhanta apparently contradictory. On same issue, you can find Maharaj sometimes speaking to somebody, what is this? So scriptural analysis is very, very tough. Without pure devotion, you cannot come into any concrete conclusion. Not possible. Is it contradictory? Simple, on same issue. You are speaking this, you are sometimes speaking this. What is the harmony? What is the balancing condition? Very dangerous. That's why we have one advice by our Guru Varga, I mean Srinivasa Acharya. What? Sarva Goswami Stokam? Nana Sasto Vichara Naika Nipuno Sadharma Sangsthapako Lokanam Hitakarino Dibhubani Manyo Saranyaka. What is that? You feel the meaning of this sloka? Here I am giving advice that all our Guru Varga, like Sarva Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Seventh Goswami, all our Guru Varga, I mean they are the personal associates of Radharani or Govinda. So they stir the whole scriptural ocean and get the cream for you. Now you are very easy to do bhajana for us, very easy, because we have already cream in our hand. Prabhupada ji, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We need not go through so many vāg, nane, pūrāṇ, these, that, ved, vidānta. What is the final goal? To get Gauranga Mahāprabhu? To they find eternal seva? That is the final. What is our final? To go to Chaitanya Mahāprabhu? By one sloka I told 3 days ago, you can remember, Yatha yatha gaura padara binde binde ta bhaktim kritapunna rasi tatha tatha usarpat hidya kasmat radha padambujo sudhambu rasi. Very nice discourse you can have on this sloka. I don't find to discuss all in details. I like where I cannot find time. So now you see, our discussion, our topic, what? Satsanga, asatsanga. Sat, asat. And how to do bhajan. Perfect bhakti. This is our topic for 3-4 days going on. Now point is that, yesterday you told one sloka, we expressed doubt on it, about it. What is that? Tusidas ji. Sadguru mile bhed batave gyan kare upadesh. Kaila ka mahila chute jo aag kare pravesh. Today I can discuss this point. So you cannot have any doubt. Now come on, if we go to Niti Shastra, there also you can find one nice sloka. Niti Shastra. Very nice sloka. What is that? Lalaye panchavarsani tare dasavarsani. Prapte tu sarasavarse putram mitravam mitravat acharet. What a unique sloka. Up to 5 years you can love your child very deeply. You can so cradle. Huh? But when your boy up to 10 years, 5 to 10, you have to, hey, what you are doing? Sit here. Don't go there. Don't speak like that. But talk. Regulation. You should put embargo. Embargo is one word we find in this world. So, restriction. But when your boy getting 16 years of age, then you should behave like a friend. Like a friend. You should not beat him. You can beat him, you can throw him, though. You can ask him. You can get bad result out of that. Again, there is one nice sloka there. Same sloka. I mean, a second part. Lalone bahavo dosa, tarane bahavo guna, tasmyat putram sisam cha, tarvet natulare. What does it mean? That is why writer speaking is 80% realized soul. Brahman, actually. He has faith for Krishna, Ram, everything. So no problem. You can say, you can, anyway, you can find there that you should chide your disciple, you should speak heavily. Always you should try to control your disciples, your son, daughter. This is the rules. Because if you always show, exhibit blind love, it can result very badly. That is why it is advice given that you should chide him. Hey, what you are doing? Speak this way. But at present, we find advice from different society. Why you are speaking so harsh? Why are you speaking this way? Then you can find. Anybody speaking the truth, they can find. Even they don't go through Niti Shastra. What about scriptural advice? Even they don't, I think they don't go to Niti Shastra. Ordinary Niti Shastra. Now, Tulsidas Goswami speaking, what speaking? Sadguru mile bhed bata. It is the duty of Sadguru to regulate you. If a guru cannot regulate a disciple, then he is the servant of his disciple. Please excuse me. I am not speaking, it is a speech by Prabhupada. If you fail, if one guru failed to regulate, control a disciple, then he is the servant of his disciple. Or he can do one thing, the disciple is not ready to obey me, then he will have to leave him. Go! Forever. Like Madhavendra Prabhupada. When Ramchandra Prabhupada giving advice to Gurudev, you see, come on, Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev, he is giving, Gurudev, why you are crying? You are Paramahansa. Huh? Foolish. I am not getting Krishna, this, that, so much pain I am feeling. Go away from me. Go forever. Get lost. I don't like to face your, see your face. If I see your face, then I cannot go climb eternal level. Go. Foolish. Madhavendra Prabhupada. And when Guru avoid a Sisha, I mean, then his condition is very bad. Then we saw Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find. Now, Ramchandra Bhai finding fault with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Supreme Lord. Your sannyas is so greedy. Mahaprabhu become very surprised. Why? Speaking like so much ant running here. You must have taken sweet rice at like that night time. Sure. You know, sannyasi, you are so greedy. Mahaprabhu gets silent because Mahaprabhu is a guru worker. Mahaprabhu exhibit. Mahaprabhu acharan is very accurate. When Mahaprabhu is grihastha, you should follow that grihastha leela. When you are brahmachari, you should follow the lila, teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in sannyas form, you should follow in toto. You need not follow anybody. You need not follow anybody. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mean Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Paraphernalia, I mean personality, is the same thing. You need not follow anybody. That's why Sarvam Bhattacharya giving nice advice in Chaitanya Satakam. When Sarvam Bhattacharya wrote 100 sloka like wind. When Sarvam Bhattacharya got full kripa from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because first of all argument going on, after that he fall down. When Mahaprabhu saw his Sarahuj, then Mahaprabhu touched him. What happened, Sarvam? Get up. He then like wind, he's speaking 100 sloka. 100 sloka. Out of that I can discuss one or two sloka, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Advent ceremony coming. We can have chance to discuss. Very nice. There you can find. So, you see, Sadguru mile Ved Bata. Ved Bata means You can find you are Vaishnava. Why you are categorized? You try to categorize. Not that. Is it in there? In all scripture. Ved Vatavya means? It is the duty of Gurudev to so he says, Maya. Don't go there. Don't go there. That society to take prasadam there. Like Guru Krishna Baba told me. Then it is not at all criticism. Because I started second sloka, what I told? Parasabhava karmani na prasansa. My Gurudev said, hey, don't go there. Don't go there. You can fall down. Don't mix with that bad guy. He's a fallen soul. Then you can say, my Gurudev criticized me. It's very good. It's not good. My Gurudev criticized me. But no. Gurudev not criticized me. Gurudev not criticized me. Actually, Gurudev liked to protect me. Gurudev liked to show me how to get, how to avoid, how to shun evil association. Otherwise, that Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj has no trace of self-interest, no smell of self-interest. Why Gaur, what? Why Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj speaking? Don't go there to hear Harikatha. Then Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj criticizes? Criticizes? You think? Paramahansa Guru Vaishnava never criticize anything. Even if I discuss Bhagavatam, you can find Paramahansa Acharya, Srila Sukhdev Goswami. Sukhdev Goswami Acharya? Whom he give initiation? Parikshit Maharaj? Where? He is not getting any mantra from him. Only here Bhagavatam. Only here Bhagavatam. What do you mean by Diksha? What do you mean by Diksha? To get Dibba Gyan. And Bhagavat itself Krishna. All mantra, Kam Gayatri, everything there, there in Bhagavat. Everything there. Bhagavat means complete, Krishna. Now, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking Bhagavatam in front of Parikshit Maharaj. So, Sukhdev Goswami is so merciful to give Bhagavatam to me. To give Krishna to me. So, through Bhagavad discourse, I mean, speech, he is giving Krishna himself. And what about Sambandha Bhavidya Prayajan Gyan? It automatically flourishes inside the heart of Parikshit Maharaj. Through Bhagavad, listen. Only by Bhagavad listen. But at present, if you get mantra, still you cannot develop Sambandha Gyan. What is this? One thing, 3 days, 2 days ago, I was discussing that if we feel that day by day, Guru Parampara, through Guru Parampara, we are losing power, then we cannot get stamina. We cannot have that kind of belief. So I told you, don't think like that. But it is true that day by day, Guru Parampara, power decreasing. At the same time, I am speaking the truth, not discussing. Because why? Those who are 100% approved by Prabhupada, mind it what I speak. Those acharya approved by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, for them I am not speaking anything. You can get it. Approved by Prabhupada means when Prabhupada manifesting Leela, not that. Even after going away from this, passing away from this, still you can approve. You can feel. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I discussed in Puri, you can remember? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Amar Agnaye Guru Haiya Taroi Desh. It is my order. You become Guru. You act as Guru. And deliver all this fallen souls. So what is the secrecy here? It is the advice of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for you to get established in Guru Tattva and Seva Tattva. Same thing. Then automatically you become Guru. Then now you go and deliver them. Now, you cannot think it that way. There is standing instruction for all any one of us can act as guru and send the whole world to hell. Not that kind of advice. You should not think it wrong way. You see? So now point is there, Tulsidas ji is speaking very nicely. Binu guru sadas binu guru bhavanidhi tarai na koi ram kipa binu sulavanasui. What is that? Binu guru, without actual sadguru, bona fide sadguru, what to speak about bhakti? Even you cannot cross this material world itself. Binu guru bhavanidhi, ocean, material ocean, ocean you cannot cross. Ram kipa binu sulabh nase. Without Ram kipa, I mean the without the kipa of Supreme Lord, you cannot have the chance to get a pure sadhu. He is ready to give his own life, but he is not at all ready to change Siddhanta. It is called Guru. You can find sometimes some devotee is speaking this Siddhanta. After that, some problem can be changed this Siddhanta. Yes, I heard. He is speaking this Siddhanta, recorded. Like, I can see, I am not criticizing. I paid dandavat to Sundaranda Vidyavina. I write so many, by the words mercy of Guru Vaishnava, I wrote about our parampara, so many books. They show that Sundaranda Vidyavina, that Sundaranda Vidyavina ji, who when was under the guidance of Prabhupada, he wrote something else. Very nice Siddhanta. But after that, when he left Prabhupada, his Siddhanta, just he is cutting his own Siddhanta. What is foolishness? I show him. Come on, he told this thing 20 years back. Now he is speaking this. He is cutting his own Siddhanta. Who is going to believe him? If you cut your own Siddhanta, who can believe you? So sometime you can find some contradictory Siddhanta. You can find some contradictory matters on single issue. But you should approach a pure Vaishnava to get solution. If manipulation, you go on thinking, what's that? I repeatedly told, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. We should think about absolute, we should speak about absolute, we should serve the absolute. At any cost, you are not going to change our Siddhanta anything. Because I have no self-interest with you all. If you all leave me forever, still I can take rest nicely and go to Vrindavan, because I was there in Suryagundu, not speaking. I am speaking Harikatha at least 8 hours, if not more, to Krishna. Vacant place, nobody there. I am speaking Harikatha to Krishna, 8 hours at least. Continuous recital to Krishna, nobody there. So get Patishtha. Only Madhugri Vika, morning time and evening time, sometimes cooking for Sujan Bhagavan, all the time, reciting. And some Brajavasi coming, I embrace them. This way. And you see, I can discuss this point, Rupa Goswami Pai's final advice. I can discuss. After some, in middle, I mean tomorrow or day after tomorrow, I cannot discuss. I am going to do some seva here. Actually, today also I complete my archan, then come, because nobody there. Anyway, so Tulsidas ji speaking, without the mercy of Krishna, I mean Ramchandra, he cannot get good association. Not possible. Without Ram Kippa, without Krishna Kippa, you cannot get. So Sadguru Mile Ved Vatame. Then Gurudev going to giving you Dibba Gyan. So Dibba Gyan, Gurudev going to give me Dibba Gyan, and if the pot is perfect, Patra, if the pot patra is perfect, then readily you can get power. I can get the power of my Guru Maharaj 100%. Because Guru Maharaj is merciful. Guru Maharaj is not going to hide anything from me because I am inclined. Even in Bhagavatam you can find a sloka. Very nice. Snigdasya sishyasya gurovo gujjam api yuto. Snigdasya sishyasya gurovo gujjam api yuto. There is no such secrecy which Gurudev cannot speak in front of an inclined devotee and disciple. So we can keep heart. We have belief, strong belief. Though we know day by day power going down, but still power is there. Who told you not power there? You are blind, you cannot see. That is your fault. You cannot see. Power flowing. Same power flowing. Otherwise who can get chance to go to? So we must believe it. So actually Sadguru Mile Ved Batave Gyan Kare Upadesh, when you are ready to accept all Siddhanta, all Acharan, all the advaishma etiquette of Guru Maharaj, then and only then you can be called Snigdho Sishyo. The title Snigdho Sishyo, tranquilly we cannot utter it. This word is not perfect. Snigdho Sishyo. There is no similar word is there in dictionary. You see, you cannot find similar. Snigdho Snigdho. So Snigdha Sishya means who can digest all the teachings of Gurudev? Who can get all Acharan, all Siddhanta, all everything of Gurudev? Ditto. Like you see, Madhavendra Puripad giving full Kipadeshwar Puripad. He bless him. Bless him. Then Ishwar Puripad having full kippa of Madhavendra. Not that Maharaj 10% less kippa coming. Not that. No shortage. Many times I speak in front of those educated society. Economics. If demand is there, then supply can be met. Demand and supply, if you put on graph chart on any object, any item, market. If you put graph chart, like in the year of 1990, how was the demand and what was the price? And in the year of 1995, demand of that object and price, how was it? This way, if you put graph and chart, you can have a hyperbolic one. You can try and see. So if demand is there, in foreign country, especially USA, England, everywhere, France, Italy, there I think so, I heard, because I never go, I am less interested to go there. I have resolution, I cannot go. So there you can find economics, a very free economics. And economics, their economics you can find, there in UK, USA, you can find their You can find their economics is free. They never try to put any embargo on it. It's free. So automatically their demand and supply automatically oscillating factor. In their society, USA, UK, European countries somewhere you can sometimes problem can be there. Sometimes some problem can be there. When in Japan, here, there, or in advanced country, you can find economics very free economy. There is no controlling. So I told that if there is demand, then supply can be met. You have demand to get bhakti, pure bhakti? You have demand? Then be sure 100% you are going to get kripa, chance. If demand is there, then supply can be made. Sadguru mile ved batave, gyan kare upadesh, kaila ka maila chute, jab aank kare pravesh. You see, usually we find coal is very black. When you put in fire, very shortly we find a molten gold color like molten. So what is this? Black. Coal is very black. But after that you can find. This change you can see. So now Siddhant is there. When, now I just told you, Snigdasya Sisyasya Gurubo Gujyam Api Uto. There is no such secrecy which a Sadguru, bona fide Sadguru, cannot speak in front of a bona fide Shatsisya. Shatsisya, honest sisya. Cannot. I mean, total thing you can get. Like Ishwar Puripad giving total treasure of Madhavendra Puripad. Total. You need not go up to that far. Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, if you go to touch his lotus feet, he say, hey, tumar sarbonash hobe, you can fall down. But one day, that Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, taking all his dust powder from his lotus feet, and giving on the head of Prabhupada. Taking from his lotus feet, taking. What is that? Very nice Siddhanta. So you see, full kipa you can get. Full kipa. So when Snigdha Sishya, you can see Snigdha Sishya means who can digest all the Siddhanta of Gurudev, all the acharan you can take up. I mean detour. Sadguru and Sasishya are the same. Yes, I can say, I can give so many examples. Srinivas Acharya, Ramchandra Gauri, I can give you one example. Very nice example. One day Srinivas Acharya entering into always they are in Nitalila, but sometime he pass away. For 3 days Srinivas Acharya not coming. Everybody young, very anxious. In one room he enter, always enjoying the leela of Radha Govinda, doing seva there. Everybody begins, what happens? Nobody can advise you what to do, what not to do, what to do. Then Ramchandra Goviraj, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, took the responsibility to know the fact. Where is my Gurudev actually? Let me see. Then Ramchandra Kaviraj sitting in meditation, I mean through Sankirtan, passing away and going to Vrindavan, entering the Vrindavan. Oh my God! He going there, he find Radharani missing his nose key, ring. So all Sakhi, they are searching in Jamuna river, they are searching. Where is, because Radharani is, he find my Gurudev, my name Srinivas Acharya, he is also. I mean, she is also, not he. Such. So you see, Ramchandra Kaviraj and Srinivas Acharya same. How I pass this remark? One day Narottama Thakur, Narottama Thakur is very tough. Someday Narottama Thakur beat Ramchandra Kaviraj, very heavily beat. After that, blood coming out, backside. Then it was found. Mark was found on the backside of Srinivasa Acharya. Then Narottama Thakur started crying like mad. Oh my God, what I do? Have some incident behind it. I have no time to discuss this, so I can discuss something. Crying. And up to the last moment, Narottama Thakur could not leave the association of Ramchandra. That's why Narottama Thakur, Ramchandra Kaviraj, Ramchandra Kaviraj, Narottama Thakur now crying. Up to the last moment of his life. Ramachandra Sangha Mange Narottama Dar Pasana Kutiba Matha Anole Pashibo Gauranga Guner Nidhi Kotha Gele Pao. Ha Kaviraj, Ha Patarugunath, always crying. And you are singing. If you don't have that kind of practical feeling, then it is useless. Who care, man? Your kirtan? Krishna is interested, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Nityananda were interested to hear your heart, the heartbeat, the oscillation, I mean the sound vibration going into your heart. With the musical, I mean, you see, when song going now, you must play kirtal properly, you must play midanga properly, rhythm should be there. If you break rhythm, that's all useless. So Krishna Bhagavan playing on flute in the eternal world. Those who are Paramahansa, they can hear clearly, very clearly. It's not Kama Gayatri. Brahma Gayatri took birth again in Brajadham. Very nice philosophy there. So you know. So you will have to harmonize yourself with the heart of your Guru, heart of your Gurudev. You will have to harmonize with the heart of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. If you fail, you can get lost in this infinite world. If you miss this chance, then you are going to. So great chance you are getting. So you see, so sat sishya, I mean snigdha sishya, you know, now you know the Siddhanta. Somebody can show you, Marasi is a very snigdha sishya. Very peaceful disciple, I mean, very tranquil. They say, no, snigdha sishya is not definition like what you are speaking, like not like that. Because we have the chance to go through Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So now nobody can cheat us. Otherwise everybody can misinterpret in front of me. Oh Maharaj, he is very snigdha sishya, you know. He is doing so many seva Gurudev. He is very peaceful. Never fight with anybody. Foolish man. I can show you shot or shot. That the fine demarcation, you can go mad. If I try to establish this demarcation, you can go mad. I cannot do bhajan, Maharaj. So accuracy? Yes. Sat or sat. That fine demarcation. So fine demarcation. So I have the chance to hear Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Kesava Goswami, who can make fool of me? You can? Nobody can make fool. But those who are neophyte devotees, new devotees, they don't have the chance to hear one pure Vaishnava, anybody can make fool of him. Huh? One nice story I can remember, I heard from my father, forefather, I see, I can remember. He is telling in America, one big mammoth gathering was there. American president speaking in front of a mammoth gathering, giving speech. Who that president, I cannot remember, maybe Abraham Lincoln, the first president, or maybe Washington, George, maybe I forget. But that is not so important. He is giving lecture. After this speaking, 50% of the American population, they are all fully. Then there a big agitation started. Why you are speaking? We are police. Huh? You must give answer to that. Then American president said, okay, wait, sorry. Excuse me. 50% of the American population, they are all wise. Started clapping. After that, oh my God, he is making fool of us. 50% wise means 50% fool. 50% fool is wise. Oh my God, he's making fool of us. This way, we are foolish. We are really foolish. We cannot understand. We always seek our self-interest. If we are really dedicated soul, then we are searching for seva. Without seva, I can die. Suffocation. As if somebody killing me. Without seva. I need seva. Pure devotees, they are searching. Those are bonded souls, they go away from pure Vaishnava. Because if I stay in front of Vaishnava, they can speak some seva. But I have no interest to do that kind of seva. So better go away. Don't go in front of pure Vaishnava. So you see. So Sadguru always giving instruction, strong instruction to his disciple. Otherwise, you see, day by day, a big problem can arise in our spiritual world. Now you can feel. You can lead your life fancifully. She can lead her life fancifully. Anybody can love. They are following their whimsical attitude. They are following. They are not following Guru Vishnu. You see? So, Amar Agai Guru Haya Taro Ides. Now you understand. Because vis-a-vis we like to discuss this point. How to avoid evil association? How to get pure association? If you don't have the chance to get pure association right now, then what to do? Then mentally you can get pure association. I put this question in front of my Guru Maharaj many times. Guru Maharaj thought he is a foolish personality, I shouldn't answer now. I repeatedly put this question. Guru Maharaj don't speak, only laughing. One day Guru Maharaj speaking. What do you mean by good association? What do you mean by pure association? I am going to pass away from this material world. So you are going to miss me? You think so? What's that? I have eternal relation with my Guru Maharaj. So still Bhakti Goma Purigashi Maharaj is there in front of me. I can solemnly say, many devotees in Chagda and many places, some old man, 80 years, 90 years, sometime Kartik Vrata, my Harikatha going on, 1 month, one month, 5 days, continuously. Some old man from outside, he is seeing one old, my Guru Padma is standing with, he told, oh, who is there speaking, and in front of Maharaj, some old man standing with stick. I can show you that man. That was my Gurudev. In Kalna also it happened. But when you are speaking, it seems some your Gurudev speaking, standing very old age, almost 100 years. See, it's true. I can feel my Guru Maharaj. I am not speaking actually. Guru Maharaj speaking, Prabhupada speaking, Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Bhavan, they are speaking. Madhu Goswami Maharaj, they are speaking in me. If I speak, think I am speaking Harikatha, I am not. I am a cheater. Then I am a cheater, you see. Now point is that when full Siddhanta, full Kripa coming into you, then like coal taking the form of golden, molten gold, then you can also can take that kind of nice feature. Real feature. So this way you can change. So you understand? So now you go back to the advice given by Prabhupada from scripture. What is that? Parashabhava karmani na prasansad nagarhe. Vishwam ekatpakam pashyana prakriti purushyana cha. So what is the analytical, discussion of this sloka? Because negative and positive, both I should discuss. If you don't know what is darkness, then what glory you can feel about light? So those who are Siddhantavid, they always speak about the light and darkness, both. So when I is speaking about the positive point, I should see this negative point, because maybe someday you can express some doubt about me. Maybe you can meet some kind of eventuality. Then you can express doubt. Maharaj told me that now I cannot tally. I cannot harmonize. Then what happens? So Prabhupada told himself, Parasabhava karmani na prasansad. But he himself pointed, hey, you are doing this way, you are doing this way. Go away from temple. Prabhupada speaking. Like one devotee is doing secretly woman association. One day, Prabhupada from Bhajan Kutir, Bhakti Vijay Bhavan, one day during Arati time, Arati going to be started. Prabhupada like wind running. Like wind. Prabhupada lying. Like lion. Coming to Chaitanya Math. Chaitanya Math, he totally is Chaitanya Math. He coming to main temple. And he now climb the temple. Through. Enter into temple. And he get one letter. That letter was kept under the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's deity, it was kept there secretly. Prabhupada go and take the letter and speak to the pujari. I say, out! Out from here. Go! Driven out. Many times we see, sometimes Prabhupada excuse somebody. Don't try to act that way anymore. Today, excuse him. So one Mahajan is very powerful. Sometimes he can chide you, second he can love you. You see, this way we find Prabhupada can know everything. Who is doing what? Where? Prabhupada can know everything. You cannot just hide. A pure Vaishnava can know everything. What you are speaking about him, backside, and understand. And he can answer accordingly. You can find when you speak Parigata, oh, I was discussing what is now he answer this way. So I get my answer now. So follow. So Parasabhava Karmani in opposition said, Prabhupada speaking for those bonded soul. One bonded soul cannot criticize another bonded soul. Cannot do it. But Prabhupada not speaking that Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj should not criticize anybody. Not, because they are not criticizing. Even if you go through Bhagavatam, I can show you, first canto, Srila Sukhdev Goswami, Paramahansa Sreshtha. Even Sukhdev Goswami is less interested about any material thing. That Sukhdev Goswami now speaking harsh, very hard against those material people. Speaking? Sa, Ashto, Kharo, Baraho speaking. Hey, he is all abusing. Speaking all darkness again. But if he is Paramahansa Sreshtha, always seeing Krishna everywhere, how is it possible for him to chide, to speak all rubbish against the material people? That is also bhakti from him. When Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj speaking, you see, Gaur Kishore Babaji one day speaking very, very hard to Prabhupada. My Prabhu, don't try to speak in front of that devotee. Don't try to teach him Chaitanya 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 Bhagavat to him. Don't! Gaurisa Vrajavan, one is speaking. My Prabhu, Vimala Prasad, Bhakti Siddhanta. My Prabhu, don't try to teach any philosophy Chaitanya 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 Bhagavat in front of that devotee, that so-called devotee. You know what he is doing? While he is reciting Bhagavatam, reciting Chaitanya Chaitanya, he put one big plate for getting pranam. Babaji was speaking. Now he is putting one big plate so that people can give pranam to him. So idiot he is. After that, Gaurakrishna Babaji was speaking. I am speaking very hard to you. Never mind my song. Amar Prabhu, my Prabhu, don't misunderstand me. Never mind. I am speaking so hard in front of you. Because to save that bonded soul, I am bound to speak. Because if you teach all secret Siddhanta to him, he can go to market and use it for earning money. Because no bhakti is there with him. So better you stop, don't speak anything. If he approach you, ignore him. Follow that point. So now point is that Prabhupada speaking this sloka for why? But because one bonded soul cannot criticize another bonded soul. It is not the rule. Because bonded soul, when criticizing another bonded soul, he is concentrating his mind on his character and behavior. Suppose now one bonded soul criticizing you. So he need to concentrate on your character, bad character, everything. So somehow he is getting bad association. He is buying, he is going to market and buying some bad association. Huh? So what dangers you see. So one bonded soul cannot criticize another bonded soul. So it is my advice, Prabhupada speaking, it is my advice, don't try to criticize other, only you try to rectify yourself. That is my last advice to you all. Prabhupada's last advice, jewel advice, we find this one of them. So this way, Now for past 3-4-5 days we are going same discussion. So you can understand, you have a clear idea about how to get pure association, how to shun, how to avoid evil association. You are attending Harikatha from a devotee. But if you can find Pratishtha, he is thinking about money, pratishtha, everything. If you attend that Harikatha, it seems that you are hearing Harikatha, but Prabhupada speaking, you are not at all hearing Harikatha. It is like Harikatha. It is not like... Harikatha means transcendental sound vibration. Harikatha means transcendental sound vibration. But here, all material sound coming to you, you have the chance to catch that kind of material sound. So now you can manipulate, you can think, wow, I am attending his Harikatha for a long time, I am not getting chance, I am not going up. Why? What is the reason? Material. So Prabhupada Meritian speaking so many sloka to give caution, put caution before us. And Jiva Goswami Pada, I told you yesterday, Bhakta Sarag Nirag Divido Bhavet. There's two kind of speaker. Who is speaking without any self-interest, what to speak about self-interest, and even there is no smell of self-interest. So you can attend Harikatha. And another kind of speaker who is always thinking about money, 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 sweeter than honey, is speaking. Always. So, big problem. Then, if you hear that kind of varikasa, what? Automatically you are getting bad association, evil association. Though it seems you are hearing arigata, doing parikrama with, but pure association about parikrama I can speak. On Ekadashi day or day after Ekadashi, I can try to discuss some point. How to do parikrama nicely, how to get pure association. That is vital point. So this way you see, parasabhava karmani na prasangsayat nagarahe. If you try to criticize other, you will have to concentrate on the factors. What factors? About his bad character, this, that. Then automatically you are getting bad association. And those who are paramahansa, for them, for paramahansa, those who are acharya, acting as acharya, bona fide acharya, for them, there is no problem. Because it is his responsibility to show you the difference between good and bad. It is not harmful activity. Because Sadguru has to do it. Sadguru has to do it. There is no way. Otherwise, how he can show that don't go there, don't go there, don't mix with that devotee, don't go there. This way speaking. So for Paramahansa, we see those who are Paramahansa, they can see everything Sadvastu. Nasato Vidyati. In Gita, we can find one. We can discuss this point. Nice look. Sometime I discuss this point. And how I told yesterday, whenever we attend one function, big function, sometime it is not it is not pure function. I mean, spiritually, it is not spiritually motivated. Sometimes we attend material function. Material speech going on. Material prasadam. Not prasadam, actually, we are getting sabji, puri, getting nice, alua, all material thing. Krishna, don't approve it. Then you are not. Prasada seva karita hai sakal prapancha joy. What's that? If you take a pinch of prasadam, then you can conquer this world. Then what is the fallacy there? We are taking so many prasadam all day and night, but there is no improvement, no development. Then what happens? Some fallacy must be there. What is that problem? Now you calculate. So prasada seva karita hai sakala prapancha joy. Prasada seva mean? This is a big discussion. And I discuss Rupa Goswami Bhadi, Dadati Pratiginnati Gujjati Prichati Gujjama Kati Bhungte Vayati is sixfold, six kind of exchanges. If you can do it a pure Vaishnava, then you are successful. And the same you are doing with bonded soul. And if you are Paramahansa, then you can give your association to that fallen soul. You can pull him up to your level. Like Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur not going to associate with that dross. Haridas Thakur never do go for any evil association. People can misinterpret. What Haridas Thakur doing? Haridas Thakur giving is the highest association. I mean, his person is giving to the cross and pulling the cross up to his own level. Now, big, big Mahanta, those who are big, big Acharya, now they are going to take darshan of that cross. Lakshahira. Kipa karo, kipa karo, kipa karo, Mataji, kipa karo. Now, praying. This. So negative and positive, both you should think. Follow, you see. So Paramahansa cannot see any fault with anybody. Can fault? Paramahansa cannot Paramahansa is in excellent level. He never cannot find any fault. Because Ramananda Sangha, the discourse between Ramananda, Ramananda Ji and Mahaprabhu, there we find. Ramananda speaking, I see Krishna inside you. What happens? You speak? I see Krishna inside you, Krishna playing on food in you. Mahaprabhu laughing. Actually, you see, you are Paramahansa Shrestha. So wherever you see, find Krishna. Don't speak lie. Speak the truth. Who are you? Mahaprabhu said, excuse me, don't speak it to anybody. I am going to unveil the truth in front of you. Don't speak it to anybody because people can think I am mad. You are mad? I am mad. So both we are mad. Don't speak like that. So Mahaprabhu, Ramananda discover, oh, hey Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, same Krishna, embracing Radharani. Now taking more complexion of molten gold, like Radharani. Radharani. Embracing Radharani. Amen. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu confessed, I am actually Krishna, I am actually Radha Govinda and Gaur, the same. Excuse me, don't speak it to anybody. So this way, you see, there we find one nice word, Jaha Jaha Nitya Pare Taha Krishna Spure. Mahaprabhu speaking. Rai Ramananda speaking. Why I find Krishna, I can see Krishna inside. Mahaprabhu try to hide himself. Actually, point is that you are Paramahansa. Anywhere you see, you can find Krishna. Jaha jaha netro pare, taha Krishna spure. And for bonded soul, what happened? Jaha jaha netro pare, taha raktamangsa spure. For bonded soul, whenever you say, oh, there is one pity God, there is a handsome boy. Now I can go into a deep philosophy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now I can go deep philosophy into Prabhupada. To show you very tough Siddhanta. Birth after birth, you cannot have this kind of chance to hear. Nobody going to speak, I think. Anymore. Very secrecy. Asasanga tyage vaishnavachar. To avoid evil association is the only etiquette. Of Vaishnava. Asasanga tyage vaishnavachar. What do you mean? To avoid evil association, that is the only duty. I mean, only etiquette he should develop. What do you mean? I cannot understand this point. Very secret point. Very secret point here. What do you mean? Sometimes some scriptural advice coming to us direct way or indirect way. Directly or indirectly. So when you are getting this advice, the asasanga tyage vaishnavachar, then another siddhanta is there secretly inside this siddhanta. What is that? Satsanga. Right. Always try to get Shuddha Siddhanta, Shuddha Sangha. To avoid asasanga means to get satsanga. Those who are Mayavadi, they can try to prove that, see, there is no such sannyasi there in the world who can have that kind of, you know, detachment like we have. We never see even a woman. So, we are pure brahmachari. But Mahaprabhu speaking, come on man, you are foolish. Who is going to care your brahmacharya? Who is going to care your sannyas brata? You can express proud, I am sannyas, I am big, so elevated soul, so I am myself exhibiting this kind of renounced order. I am sannyasi. Kopi na banto, kholu bhagavanto. Vedanta Bhakyeshu Sadaramante. Sadaramante. This kind of slok there in Mahabharata. They think we are devotee. But devotee means dedication. But dedication is not there. Dedication, the matter is totally off from their life. They don't like to exhibit. That's why in Bhagavatam you see, Arujyakichena param padaha patati adho anadrita yusmat angrayo. Anadrita yusmat angrayo. Oh, Brahma, now speaking the truth. Oh, Krishna, oh, Supreme Lord, those who are Mayavadi, they always try to avoid seva. They don't care for seva. They like to get that Brahma path. They are climbing Brahma path very tough. Very tough astuti and penances. But we Gauriya, we sing this way. Vairagya vidya nija bhakti yoga shikshartam ekam purusho purano Sri Krishna Chaitanya Sarira Dhari Kipam Budiriyastamaham Prapadde. The our Vairagya is Vidya. And their Vairagya is not Vidya, Avidya. Follow. Those are Mayavadi, they exhibit here. But they are Avidya. Our Vairagya, Raghunath Swami exhibiting Vairagya that is coming from heart. Krishna is very interested to see that kind of vairagya. Mahaprabhur bhakta ganer vairagya pradhan jaha dekhi prasanyaham gaur bhagavan. Mahaprabhu all personal associates, they are naturally they have that kind of dedication and detachment. They automatically, like mathematics, if this straight line passing through this point, automatically is going to satisfy this point, like mathematics. So you need not speak that. So automatically, Mahaprabhu bhakta ganer vairagya pradhan, those who are personally associated with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, automatically they have scientific vairagya, which can back you to get pure bhakti, to do seva. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu become very interested to see the vairagya detachment of Sanatana Goswami. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is very much interested to see the detachment of Raghunath Das Goswami. But he is less interested to see my vairagya. Because I am kapat. Big point. So automatically, I can show sloka from Bhagavata here, there, that vairagya is an automatic factor. Tyag, vairagya, this kind of the automatic factor. I can show you from Bhagavata sloka, this, that. Huh? I can explain this sloka. One time I cannot discuss so much point. So arujya krichena param padam tataha patati adho anadrita yusmat angrayo. They don't like to serve your lotus feet. They don't care. They never confess the eternal existence of your lotus feet, your eternal lila. They don't go. That's why they are elevated up to that one. Again fall down. They are not doing seva. But one devotee, actually Prabhupada told, I can speak, that more or less we are all Mayavadi. Whole world can strike against me. What do you speak, Maharaj? I am not speaking Prabhupada. I can explain this point. I can explain. I can prove. So this way, you see, from Chaitanya Charitamrita, you see, when we get this kind of advice, what kind of advice? Asasanga tyagai vaishnavachar. Then, this secret advice is automatically there. You need not play your head that you are now advised to go for satsanga always and every time uninterrupted way. We should go for. There should not be any break. So one Paramahansa always doing satsanga. Always. So Prabhupada speaking, asasanga tyage vaishnava achar, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu again discussing this point. Do you know what do you mean by asasanga tyage vaishnava achar? Asasanga means those who are women association there, and those who are not devotee of Krishna, those who are material man. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu categorized this two division. One is those who are going, those who are always seeking woman association, and second, those who are getting the association of material people. Krishna Bhaktuar. Trishangi ek a Krishna Bhaktuar. Krishna Bhaktu. In Sandhi, in Vyakaran, you will have to split those who are knowing grammar. Then Krishna plus Abhaktu, Krishna Bhaktu. O plus A. This is Vyakaran. Nice. You have to know, because otherwise outside people can come to Gaudiya Society. They are all foolish people there in Gaudiya Society. Nobody can explain in front of us. So we like to see new devotee can come up with fireful Siddhanta. That is my secret seva, know it for sure. I am not going to make any temple, nothing. But I am going to see that new devotee can come and learn Siddhanta. That is my secret seva, given by Prabhupada and Guru Varga. Know it for sure. I cannot make any resolution. I cannot go to foreign country. I cannot ask anything. If you are interested, come on. So you see my point. So now, outside people cannot understand. What do you mean by Stri Sangha? It's very clear. Woman association? No man, not so easy. Woman mean Yashit Sangha. Yashit Sangha. Yashit Josha. In Sanskrit, if you go to the synonym, you can find Yosha mean if you have any idea to enjoy him, then you are doing Yashit Sangha. Any mother, a Mataji, if she is interested to get the association of this young boy, then she is doing woman association. Understand? Very secrecy there. Tough secrecy. So for you also woman association, for him also woman association. Yashit Sangha is the open term. Very secret, I can show you. If you go, if you like to grow through the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because anyway I am going to discuss everything under the light of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's siksha. So I can discuss. How Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can find in material world, some ethically, some person is very elevated. Ethically. In this material world. And all worlds giving salute to him. Oh, so nice. He giving donation, this, that, man. So nice character, everything. And as per Vaishnava Siddhanta, maybe he is the lowest creation of this world. Whereas the whole world giving honor to him. You see, the secret Siddhanta. Whereas whole world going to give garland to him. Whereas Vaishnava Acharya is going to go like stool and urine. Useless. So secret Siddhanta. You cannot understand. You have to do bhajan. You have to do kirtan daily. Every time to satisfy Krishna. You must sit in a room alone and play on kirtan. Kartal. Pasani kutibo matha analepo sibo gauranga guner nidhi kothagile pavo. You should sing. You should do kirtan. Feel. Because inside all this kirtan, when we are Narottama Thakur, all kirtan, by Guru Bhargava, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He has some birja, some power, vitals there. Maybe it is in the form of kirtan. Ma, I can read this kirtan. No. If you read and kirtan, this is kirtan, if you do recite, inside that itself you can get power. Because power is, it is empowered. Kirtan is there, it is already empowered. Narottama Thakur, after shedding so many tears, after that he is writing one line. Narottama Thakur was shedding so many tears. After this he is writing one line. That one line, if I can follow in my whole life, I need not go through anything. I can straightway go to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. 100%. There is no doubt. First of all, you will have to develop strong faith towards Shuddha Guru Vaishnava and scriptural. Shuddha Shabde Kahe Shudhiro Vishas. Strong belief, 100% belief, that if I do Krishna Bhakti, everything is done for me. I have no other duty. Be you are Grihastha, be you are Vrnaprastha, be you are Sannyasi, be you are Brahmacharya, no matter. Gopi Vartur Padakama Layaru Dasu Dasanu Dasaha. Naham Vipur Nachanya Narpatira Napi Vaishwana Sudro Naham Varni Nachagun Gepatira Namanasya Tirva Kinto Pradhan Nikhila Paramananda Purnamita Dher Gopi Vartur Padakama Layaru Dasu Dasanu Dasaha. That is your identity. You are not a woman. You are not a man. You are not an old man. You are not brahmachari. You are not sannyasi. That's why one Paramahansa, when giving you advice, when Paramahansa Gurudev giving you advice, inside his heart there is no discrimination. He is speaking only to give you advice. You cannot imitate your Gurudev. Don't like to criticize anybody, don't like to appreciate anybody. What do you mean? I cannot criticize, okay, but if I appreciate, then what happens? What from? Maharaj, same thing. If you appreciate one material person, you will have to concentrate on his material quality. Material quality, yeah. No, maybe it's good quality, but material quality. But you have to, when you are appreciating one material person, one freedom fighter, this, that, oh, giving silver. Today is that. Then you are concentrating on material qualities. So automatically you are doing where sushi? So you cannot appreciate, at the same time, you cannot criticize. But Prabhupada sometimes speaking. এই জগতে আমাদের পরপ্রশংসা ভজনের অনুকূল হতে পারে. ইন দিস মেটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড সামটাইম ইফ ইউ অ্যাপ্রিসিয়েট সামবডি ইট ক্যান গিভ সাম বেনিফিট টু আস ফর কৃষ্ণ ভজন. নাও ইউ ক্যান, হোয়াট ইউ ক্যান আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড, ফাইটিং কনফ্লিকশন, হ্যাঁ, অন সিঙ্গল পয়েন্ট. নাও প্রভুপাদ স্পিকিং দিস, নাও স্পিকিং দিস, সেম থিং, সেম প্রভুপাদ স্পিকিং দিস. সামটাইম ওয়েন ইউ আর ইন মেটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড, if we appreciate somebody, it can give some benefit for our Krishna bhajan. But that kind of fine accuracy cannot develop inside you right now. Very fine accuracy. Pure devotees, they can see everything like mirror. Like radar. You see, if a fighter plane coming in board, hey, fighter plane coming. And in the picture there in radar. Automatically, pure heart. So try to eliminate all desire, anything. Try to think this material world is like dream. And if you are, then I can discuss from Sikhastha, Yacheto Dharpana Marjana. At the same time, I can discuss from Pobodhanu Saraswati Pad, one slope. Nice slope there. Koivalla narakayate iti dasa pura akasa puspayate duddantendriya kala sarpapatale pratkhatatam strayate vidhi mahendadishya kitayate jat koruna kataksha vaivavatam Visham purna sukhayate jat korona kataksha vivavatam tam gauramevastam. So, vis-a-vis I can discuss chetodharpana margana. What is that? How you can tell it? So you should do bhakti, pure bhakti. Automatically you can develop that kind of IQ, pure vision. Sometimes Gopad used to speak, those who are pure Vaishnav, they have no angle in their vision. Follow? You understand? You do mathematics in student life? There is no angle in their vision. What do you mean? Because if one point is there, if we put one straight line through intersecting that middle point, two way, then one straight line we can get. We can draw the line. Huh? In school, now actually point is there, definition of straight line already changed. When we when I was a student, I heard a straight line mean only it can have length, no breadth. And now advanced scientists they are saying it cannot happen so. But if length is there, breadth must be there. Maybe very small. Now those who are teacher of school, they as per the advice of scientists, they are giving us the conception of a straight line. How? They are lighting a torch and showing you a straight line, pencil ray. You see pencil ray going? Huh? Pencil ray. There is no length. Length is there, but breadth is not there. Pencil ray. Understand? Pencil ray, you understand. Bunch of ray coming out of that. One ray, if you choose, you cannot find any breadth. So this way we are developing our... So, one point, one straight line intersecting that point, middle point, if you extend that straight line both way, then if you try to get the conception of angle, then like clock you see, middle, clock going clockwise, running this way. So, with the horizontal line, every time that stick is going this way, making one angle, every time, this angle. Maybe sometime 5 degree angle, sometime 15 degree angle, sometime 45 degree angle, sometime 60 degree angle. Sometime 90 degree angle, sometime 180 degree angle, sometime 360 degree angle. When 360 degree angle you can get? When you get straight line full round, then going and come to the starting point, then you can get 90, 90, 180, 90, 90, 180. Then 360 degree. So 360 degree angle mean what Prabhupada mean to say, one Vaishnav looking anywhere, there is no aperture, no angle. Angle mean there is no disturbance of his vision. He can see clearly. Everywhere, anywhere you look, you can see. Everything is Krishna. Follow? This kind of visions you should develop fast. Slow but steady, win the race. I cannot misguide you. Better you don't come to me. I cannot misguide you. This is more dangerous. Those who are misguiding their disciple, with disciple, Mahaprabhu said, Sha Shishya, with all Shishya, they are going to hell. All Shishya and Gurudev himself, oh, they are going to hell. Because they are misguiding. You see, now, I can discuss this point after some 1 or 2 days. I can again discuss this point. So you see what I was discussing this point? At 360 degree angle, Vaishnav, they have no aperture, they can see all clearly. That's why there is no impediments, there is no fault in their vision. There cannot be any fault. Satya. This way, you can see clear. So, sat and asat, this accuracy is so fine. Now I can discuss this point 2 days after, I think, that how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is showing us. I mean the lila of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is the meaning? In each and every time. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, each and every time, sitting, standing, going, showing, speaking anything, in each and every time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibiting some sort of Siddhanta Lila. But you cannot see because you are blind. Each and every time, fraction of second. Because Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is thinking, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressing one Lila, he is expressing countless Lila. I cannot count even. Even Brahma cannot count it. One Lila, you see, one Lila Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but through one Lila, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is exhibiting countless things. Now, I repeatedly requested you to go through Jagadan by Jagadan na Pembivartha. I told you. You read it. Repeatedly you will have to read. If you like to save your bhajan life, it is my request. You must read Jagadan na Pembivartha. Jodi pranay rakhite chao gaurange shane, choto haridaser katha thaki janamane. What do you mean? If you like to keep a sweet relation with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you must remember the incident of Chatharidas. Now we go back to Gambhira, we go back to Nilachal to understand the actual meaning of Satsanga and Satsanga. Day by day, if not more, 1 year I can discuss them by the mercy of Guru Arjuna. Wonder from Bhagavatam, from different scripture. Go on discussing. If you are lucky, you can understand this point. Then in Purushottam Dham Nilachal, we see now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibiting Sannyas Lila. Sannyas Lila. And that Sannyas Lila is excellent Lila. Nobody can cross. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibiting Vairagya, that is also excellent. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibiting that I am Bhagi, I am enjoyer, that is also excellent form. Vaishajyasya samagyasya virjasya jasasya sriya. So many, I can discuss this point. Anything and everything exhibited by Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all excellent. Nobody can beat Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Asaman urdho, not equal, not more than that. You know, those who are doing mathematics, previously we were student, it is almost equal to, it is, you can point out this after one state line. Not equal, almost equal, two. So you see, not equal to, not greater than. This way you will have to think very clearly. Then if you go back to Chaitanya Lila, then how Mahaprabhu is so careful, you see. Vrindavan Das Thakur writing in Chaitanya Bhagavatam that in whole Lila, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never exhibit the form, the form of woman enjoyer. Never. Stri hano naam Prabhu, elila na sunila kani. Mahaprabhu speaking, I am sannyasi, look. Mahaprabhu speaking, giving alarm, warning to me. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, see, I think I am sannyasi. But see, I have no right to hear the name of a woman. Mahaprabhu speaking. You can think I am sannyasi. I have no right to enjoy well, nice bed, nothing. I can show you Lila of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one by one, very nice Lila. Then satsanga, you can grow concept, nice, accurate conception. Devai. Mahaprabhu speaking, you think I am sannyasi. I am an elevated soul. Ami je sannyasi. I think I am sannyasi. But I have no right to hear the name of woman. What to speak about watching one woman? I cannot say. Mahaprabhu speaking. So tough is he. If I hear the name of woman, or if I did see one, model of woman, that is also dangerous for me. Mahaprabhu speaking, I am not speaking. It can put some bad reaction inside my heart. Jabahi suni stri srihano naam bikar pae mo tonu mon pran. Mahaprabhu speaking. I can explain this part very carefully. If I see the model of woman, daru prakriti hare munarapi mon, even one model made of wooden structure, you see, wooden. Daru prakriti hare munarapi mon, even these are mani rishi. They can also break their patience. What about you and me? Mapo speaking. Sri Hananam Jabahi Shuni Tavahi Bikar Pai Mortonumon. Sti Dorsane Stir Rahe Oicha Konjon. Sri Dorsane Stir Rahe Oicha Konjon. Sri Nam Jabahi Shuni Tavahi Bikar Pai Mortonumon. Sti Dorsane Stir Rahe. Oisha Konjon, I can discuss this point next day. Vancha Kalpadravashi Kipa Sindhu Bhavisha Patitalang Pavane Bhavishna Vyo Namo. You cannot have any question. You have question? I give answer to all.
Yes, Maharaj, it's only one question related in something which yesterday I heard from Srila Bharati Maharaj. You can need to explain. Because he explained that Prahlad Maharaj, he didn't accept his two teachers, Sanda and Amar.
Yes.
Because even though they were teaching everything from the scriptures, Srila Maharaj says that they were only learning the scriptures, but without understanding the deeper meaning of the scriptures, this teaching was misleading him. So he was not accepting him.
Yes.
So what was my understanding?
About any such material guru, if there.
This is like connected with a material guru. But we can have also in our Vaishnava society.
Okay. I already give answer, but you couldn't understand. Many times you can answer. Many times. Point is that you will have to follow Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj, he is a Mahajan. 12 Mahajan, one Mahajan. We should follow Prahlad Maharaj, Bharati Maharaj, speaking right. We should follow Prahlad Maharaj. What Prahlad Maharaj did, we have to do. In front of me, if I see some senior devotee, he is speaking all rubbish. So, I will have to hear it, but I cannot accept it. Or I can go away from that place. Understand, my friend? If they don't accept in their own life, then we cannot hear that kind of philosophy. If they are not established in darshan, those who are pure vision, they are established in. Then they can speak. Because Sandhya Marga, they are speaking sometimes scripture, economics, orthaniti, rajaniti, everything teaching. But Prahlad Maharaj is not ready to accept because they are not bona fide guru. Material guru. I also learned something from material guru. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also exhibited this lila. Vidyasagar Maharaj. Vidyasagar, one learned man, he learned something from Bhaktivinoda Thakur. It's a lila, this kind of lila. So Prahlad Maharaj also exhibited this lila. He is learning something from some Sandamarka. So but he is not going to accept in his own life. I mean for Krishna Bhajan he is not accepting. A material thing. I can explain this one. Very nice. You can go, you can laugh. Very nice discussion I can do. Many times when I read, explain Bhagavad Gita, I do usually, I can show you. Very nice. So anything else?
For the Parasvabhava, Parasvabhava Karmani.
Parasvabhava Karmani.
I want to ask, one is fully material people and fully devotee, surrendered. But then there are materialists who become devotees, like new devotees. And then if we praise them, saying that you have this very nice quality of wanting to serve.
We can allow you to go up, have, go up and up.
You have very nice quality of always
Yes.
Then is that...
What is the balance you should maintain?
Yeah, is that considered that we are, you know, praising their material qualities? Because actually this is a quality that they are born with. It's not a quality that's born out of devotion.
Actually.
Like the 26 qualities of a devotee. So, are we then going down by praising them? Because we are trying to make them enthusiastic in devotion.
Yes. Actually, point is that before speaking anything, first point, I must get established myself. Before speaking anything. Now, point is that if he is 50% material and 50% spiritual, mixing, in that case, Guru Vaishnav can praise him. You can sometimes praise, but be careful inside heart. I must be careful. I am not praising material quality. You must be alert about this point. That I am not making any mistake. I am making any mistake or not? Be careful. And because you have no idea about 80% material he is, or 20% spiritual, or 20% material he is, or 80%, you don't have any idea? Follow. Then what to do? You have to do Nam Bhajan and Kirtan, automatically you can go to that power. Even in Jaiva Dharma, I can show you, Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj one there in Sivasangan there. Two boys, young boys coming from Sinatpur. You can go through. There you can find that they are coming in front of Babaji Maharaj. They are expressing their own feeling that we are, as per your advice, we are doing Harinam this time, we develop this kind of feeling. Now what to do? Then Babaji Maharaj guide, now you are up to this way. But that duty you cannot carry out, that kind of duty. So a little bit you can do. Okay, you are doing nice bhakti, Prabhu. You are, that you can. But inside you should be very careful.
Like Srila Pujabhas Bhakti Pramod Puri Maharaj wrote in an offering to Pujabhas
yes.
That when such personalities are born, Krishna bestows the qualities already
there.
In them.
So but sometimes they are acquiring quality, getting quality. Yes. In that case, we can give inspiration to them. No harm in it. But you should catch the lotus feet of a Gurudev very carefully. I mean, you should get in contact with fire so that you don't lose your color. Be careful. You see, I am praising, suppose in front of you I am praising one boy. That is for me, it is some advantage for my Krishna Bhajan. But you see Maharaj praising him. But anyway, we should get in touch continuously with Guru Vaishnava. And don't understand. If now I give you an example. One iron piece is black in nature. You can see black. But when coal or iron piece, if I put into fire, after some time, it takes the form of gold, molten gold. Again, if I put this piece of iron or piece of coal out of that fire, after 1 hour, half an hour, I can find, again it converted into black color. Remember this example. Whatever you do, you can put question before me. First, be careful and sincere about this point. Are you in contact with Guru Vaishnava? Are you in contact with fire all the time? Then you cannot miss your color. Now you can praise one man. What wrong in it? Follow. Be careful. This is vital point. But if you miss your own position, Maharaj, I am praising, what wrong I am doing? Then you are losing. Always get in touch with.
The question is on two levels. One is praising the person in front of that person. Which you are trying to inspire, see, you have such nice
person. That Guru Vaishnava can do.
Yeah. Okay. And the other thing is that you are seeing a devotee come up, as even I am not 100% devotee, I am also maybe 50%, 40% like that. So, similarly, we have other devotees around us. And then we say, oh, I am discussing not in front of that person, but with someone else. That, oh, this devotee has such a nice, you know, he's so honest, he's so ethical, this, that, whatever. So then are we getting the fault of praising someone's...
It depends upon your situation. It depends upon how you can keep balance. How you can keep balance, it depends upon. If you can keep balance, right track, then there's no harm. Understand my point? And you don't understand. More clearly, actually, if you praise about that man, you keep in mind, I am not praising material quality. Some quality he is accepting from pure Vaishnava, that quality now manifested in his own life, I am praising that quality. And that quality is not material quality.
Okay.
Understand? And some material quality can be there. That quality. Yeah. But you will have to understand very carefully. Otherwise, big problem. So, if you like to speak some Harikatha in front of a neophyte devotee, you can speak. But actually, if there is no power inside Harikatha, he is not going to get 100% benefit. Maybe 10% he can get inspiration. Understand? So it is your duty to bring him in front of a pure Vaishnava. It is your duty. Now, hey, you hear from me, I actually want to come and meet that Vaishnava. Then you are honest. Spiritually you are honest. And if you like to get name and fame, oh, you can say, I do cannot show we are pure devotees. Then you have some mascharya. Inside your heart. Big problem. So you see, follow my point. Very carefully you will have to. So pure Vaishnava, you can bring. Because pure Vaishnava are speaking, they have power. They can get, that battery can get charged very quickly. And again we are losing charge. So again you put in charging. Harikatha, Harikirtan. Even pure Vaishnava is not there in front of you. Chaitanya Bhagavata, Chaitanya, you heard from that Vaishnava, you have DVD and thousands of Harikatha, Bengali, English, Hindi, Sanskrit, you can hear, you have the chance, now advanced, scientifically we are advanced. So now is I stop my speech, Panchakalpa Durvasya Ke Basindha Bhavishya, Patitanang Pavana Pavishya.